Call of Duty points are now in Infinite Warfare. If you want the best way to get free Call of Duty points, click the link down in the description, install the app, and start getting yourself some free Call of Duty points today. Yo, what is up, guys? It's the Goblin, and welcome back to another Call of Duty Infinite Warfare video. This video is going to be another episode of How to Get Better at Infinite Warfare, where you guys ask me any questions in the comment section down below that has to do with COD Infinite Warfare, and then I answer them in the video. Today's video, let's go for 2,000 likes. I have like 6 or 7 questions I'm going to be answering here, but before we get into that, I have a sponsor for this video. Usually I tend to get sponsors for this series. Today's sponsor is earn.gg, and this website is really awesome. The link for it will be in the description. What you can do on this website is you can earn points, which you can turn into real money, which you can use, you know, PayPal or Bitcoin, or you can use that money to get yourself some Call of Duty points or some CSGO skins, whatever you want to do with it. And how you get that is, how you get this money is through earn.gg. You can complete surveys and get points, or you could even, an easier way is just to watch ads. You could just start the player going and you can just watch ads and you can let it run while you're at school, come back home, and you will have a few dollars to, you know, use for COD points or use for supply drops, which is really easy if you have a computer. You don't really have to be doing anything. You can be literally AFK earning points and earning money through this site. It's a really awesome site. My referral link will be down in the description. Please go over there, check out earn.gg if you guys want to get some free, you know, COD points or some free PayPal or Bitcoin money while basically being AFK. Awesome site. Drop a like on this video, 2,000 likes, and let's get right into the questions. First question I have here is from Zelly321. I'll throw the comment up on the screen right now. He says, what are the best variants to go for if you don't have a lot of salvage? Now, this is a very good question because a lot of the time I'm talking about epic guns that are really good, legendary guns that are really good, but those cost a lot of salvage. They cost, you know, 2,000 for a legendary and then 4,000 for the epic, which is a ton of salvage, especially if you don't spend that much on supply drops. So what he means here is, what are some of the best variants to go for if you don't have a lot of salvage? Now, most of the common variants are not the best. There's some common variants that give you something good, like the ones that have extended mags built in on them, or the ones that have, you know, reduced recoil. Those are going to be the best versions of the common ones. But the real variants you want to focus on if you do not have a lot of salvage are going to be the rare ones. You know, it's going to cost you 200 to get the common, and it's going to be 500 more to get the rare. But there's a big step up, you know, going from 500 salvage to 2,000 or 4,000. And rare variants are the ones that, you know, common variants only have one thing on them that helps you. Rare variants always have two, and usually you can find some variants that are very good. Now, what are the best variants to go for? This, of course, all depends on what sort of player you are. If you are an assault rifle player, if you are an SMG player, but what I recommend doing is focus in on those rare variants, because 500 salvage is easily attainable through mission teams. You won't even need to worry about supply drops, really, and focus in on those rare variants that have two things and where both of them help. You know, ones that have, you know, some of the rare variants might have things that say every 5 kills you get a new tactical or something like that, but there's going to be some rare variants that have two things, you know, reduced recoil and increased damage range or something like that. Two things that help you, even just help you a little bit, go ahead and snatch up that rare variant. That will help you a lot with your gameplay on a gun that you do use, of course. Next one is from It's Atrocity. He says, any tips on getting streaks / nukes? Now, this is a very good question. Of course, to get streaks, you're going to have to stay alive, and to get nukes as well. And my number one tip for going for these would be to play on the outskirts of the map and to play a stealthy playstyle. I talk about stealthy playstyles a lot because it works good in this game. You know, I never talked about it in Black Ops 3 because Silencer was really bad. You know, the stealth perks were not very good in that game. Stealth was not the way to go in Black Ops 3. The way to go was just full on power rushing, using the best guns, getting kill streaks. In this game, the streaks aren't the most powerful. You know, there's some good ones. And to get a nuke, you're gonna have to get 25 kills in a row with the same gun. So what I mean is you gotta stay alive, stay the outskirts of the map, use a stealthy class, Silencer, maybe Ghost, and use a gun that you are comfortable with, of course, and that's the way you're going to be able to get big streaks as well as nukes. Another tip for getting big streaks is, of course, you're going to want to run Hardline. Hardline is so damn helpful in this game. If you're talking about, I don't know if you necessarily mean streaks as in like a gun streak, but if you're talking about a kill streak, Hardline, Hardline, Hardline every single damn time if you guys want to get kill streaks. And also Combat Focus can help you get streaks as well. But for nukes, it's all about stealth. It's all about playing that smart sort of play style. Next question is from the Atlas Gamer. He says, when people say play smart and don't rush, I don't try to rush, but I end up camping and getting no kills. How can I play smart and die less? Now, this is a good question because there is a very fine line. I know a lot of people like to play very slow or very, very conservatively, but you do not want to end up camping where you only get 5 kills every match. That's going to be boring. So a thing that I come up with for people that play, I don't really play a slow play style at all, so I'm not the best person to ask about this, but what I would say about playing the slow play style but still wanting to get kills is when you're moving up, if you want to, you want to stay alive, you don't try to rush, move up behind your teammate. So if you see 2 teammates going into a doorway, move up behind them because you're going to be safe there unless there's 3 or 4 enemies, which is very unlikely. Even if your 2 teammates die, you'll be there, the enemy will be weak, and you'll be able to clean up that kill. So if you want to, move up a little bit, but you're sort of maybe scared or you're used to playing a more campy play style, use your teammates sort of as bait, especially in TDM. If I see a teammate running into the dome place on Genesis, I'll follow him up because there's not really any risk there, and it's moving without risk. That will definitely help you for that question, Atlas Gamer. Next question we have here is from Aiden7Vlogs. What is the best specialist? Now, of course, this depends on your playstyle and everything like that. There's 2 combos that you can never go wrong with. Mana Arms, as well as the Reactive Armor under the Merc. I love that one. And the other one is going to be under the first guy, the Warfighter. You're going to want to run the Ping and the Claw. Those 2, either of those, you can pretty much never go wrong with. There's also some really good combos for, under like the FTL and under the Skinny Bot, the people that are going to be more rush-oriented. But those 2 are the ones that you're never going to go wrong with them. And those are basically the safe, strong choices. And you'll see me running those in probably 75-80% of my game gameplays. Next question is from Will718. Your number one tip should say play on a computer monitor. So this isn't really a question. It's sort of him telling me what to say. And he's basically saying playing on a computer monitor is a big tip to get better, which I have a different sort of comment about this. Now, what the benefit is to playing on a computer monitor or playing on not even a computer monitor, to be honest, just a smaller TV. I, in MW3, when I was at my pub stomping, kind of at my pub stomping prime, I get triple Moabs, I played on a TV, just an HD TV that I got for free off of Craigslist. When I started YouTube, I didn't really have much money. I was just, a normal teenage kid. And I went out for free, and I got a HD TV that was sort of a small one for free off of Craigslist from a guy. Of course, I went with my dad. I wanted to be safe, And then that was, a huge key to me helping me get those gameplays. And a computer monitor, of course, is going to have a faster reaction time or a faster response time than that big fat HD TV I got for free off Craigslist. But the main key about your monitor, about your TV, is you want a smaller one. If you have a bigger TV, say you're playing on your uncle's 60-inch screen, to look at the minimap, Call of Duty is a lot of looking minimap right onto your reticle, minimap, reticle, minimap, reticle, looking left, right, and if you're playing on a 60-inch, 60-inch huge screen, you're going to have to turn your head to look at the minimap. Not only is that going to hurt your neck, but your reaction time is going to be a lot slower than if you're on a 20-inch monitor, and I just have to move my eyes a millimeter to see between the minimap and between the actual action where the game is taking place, and that's what I have to say about that. Smaller TVs are always going to be better, and monitors are really good, but I wouldn't say it's the number one tip. To be honest, the number one tip is, if you're going to buy equipment, it's all in the headset and in the controller. Those are the most important things. SCUF controller can help you extremely amount. Headsets can help you out so much too, because you can hear things on a headset that if you're just playing it through the speakers or through the TV, you can't really hear a guy's footsteps, or you can't really tell where the footsteps are coming from. But if I have a headset, I have a left ear and a right ear. It's really simple. Oh, I hear 2 guys to my right. Better aim down sights around this corner. Next question is from Byron Hernandez. He says he likes the minimap so much that he rage quits when the enemy calls in a counter UAV. Now, I sort of agree with you here, man. I freaking hate not having a minimap. I look at my minimap more than I look at the actual screen, to be honest. And there's a simple tip for you here, Byron, and that tip would be to run hardwired. It's a third perk, and it counters counter UAV. So if they get a counter UAV, it's not going to affect you at all. It also counters about 5 or 6 other things. Hardwired is an awesome third perk, and it's between that and Marksman for my favorite third perks in the game. Make sure you definitely test that out, Byron, and that will be a very good third perk if you're affected by a lot of things that you like counter UAV. Anyway, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Let's drop 2,000 likes on this thing. I'd really appreciate that. Smash that freaking like button, boys. I want to see 2,000 likes on this video when I check it back. I'd really appreciate it, and thanks for watching. Subscribe for Cookie and Don't Lookie, and I'm out. Peace.